All right, that's it. That's how it ended. Not good for Enyimba. Nigerian champions losing that game by 2-1. Let me quickly bring to the studios my first guest on the program tonight. Onye Bochumachukwu joins me on the show now. Onye, thank you for joining us on Sports Tonight. Not a good one. You've been ruminating on this since that game ended. And for you, you said Enyimba should have gotten something out of this game.
Yeah. I mean, they are walking a tightrope, like you said. Defensive blunders doing. You know, against Zamalek, the same issue. You know, two center backs not
clearing their lines. Clearing their lines. Conviction.
Always flat footed, always on the same line. That is the same way that Bassem Mosi got the goal for Zamalek in Port Harcourt. You know, just picked a hole in between the two center backs. And how can you defend in such a manner that the striker controls the ball and turns and shoots at your goal? So I think defensively, Enyimba has been very, very poor. And I don't know how they're going to do it. You see, they are doing a disservice to the reputation of this club. This is a club that won the CAF Champions League in 2003 and 2004.
Look at the clearing. You know, you are clearing the ball, you are going down. You can't stand on
so
your feet.
So feeble. You went down to the ground so easily. That is not even part of the rules of defending. Mm. You must stay on your feet. You must, before you go down for the ball, you must be very, very sure that you're going to
get the ball.
Yeah, so I think...
But the positive, of course, that, Dario Jo is goal. Good goal.
Yeah.
Maybe that goal will count for something at the end of the day. If it comes down to the away goals rule,
that should be one of the
and
best.
If they end up on the same number of points with Mamelodi Sundown, maybe an away goal could just be the magic for Enyimba.
Yeah.
It's tough, but it's not impossible.
But as it is now, they are without any points. They have considered two goals, scored only one goal, no point at all. You know, so they must win their next home game against Sundowns and try to get something in Egypt. It's very difficult, but like you said, nothing is impossible. I think first and foremost, they have to reorganize this team. I see a lot of changes doing. You know, when we went to Uganda, some of the players that participated, you know, are not in this team. The team keeps on changing. No consistency.
Dario Jo that scored that goal, we know him very effective as a defensive midfield player.
Absolutely.
But he's being forced to play as a right back because anybody do not have a reliable right back. And that also, for me, raises a few questions about how do you recruit to go on the continent and you don't have cover in some key positions like right back, like center back, like in the attack. Enyimba is paying heavy price for that.
And I think it's very much like Enyimba that we used to know. You know, in Uganda, after we came back, I raised that issue that the right back is very weak. The goal they considered in Kampala was, you know, from the right back. He literally, you know, accompanied the striker to score that goal. And we have been vindicated. Dario Jo is not a natural right back, but for some times now, against MFM, he was deployed to that position. And he has been playing that position.
He played that position today and scored this goal.
So you can
imagine how much more
effective
he would have
been if he had played in a natural position as a defensive midfielder. So I think they need to recruit and recruit well. I think lack of depth, the exit of Maxine Ojobo, you know, who used to play for Enyimba in that position last season, was really, really felt, and they have not been able to fill that vacuum. It's over now because you can't recruit any player at this point.
The group stage is on.
So Paul Aibogun and his assistants will have to look for a way, try to reorganize this team, bring some belief, and scoring goals have been a problem for them. They have played two matches, scored one goal, and considered three goals.
And they had a lot of chances in this game as well to have scored a few more goals.
You brought in Ifeanyi Onuribo, yes, highly experienced, but he has not been, as a striker, you have
a
to
lot
be,
of energy, yeah, a lot of running, but
the way
the
you
got product
is the your conversion rate, and he has not scored any. He played against Zamalek, and now this game. So, for me, some of the players they brought in has not really, you know, added any value to the squad. You know, maybe they will have to look inwards and look at some players. You know, they still have some players, you know, in the team, and try to see how they can revive their campaign, starting from the next home game against Mamelodi Sundowns. Mm. If they draw that game, then technically they are out.
No, they don't have any other option now. They've got to win their next two games to stand any chance, because they have 0 points. The two teams in that group already have 3 points. So if you are not winning your next game, you are out.
Yeah.
And Clearly, if you are not winning your next game, you are out.
And they can draw inspiration from ASEC Mimosas. You know, ASEC Mimosas went to the same stadium where we lost to the Pharaohs of Egypt and beat El Ahly 2-1 just today. So, I mean, anything is possible.
Mm. All right, let's take a look, before we go on a break, let's take a look at the results from match day two of the CAF Champions League. Oyin just talked about it. Enyimba should have drawn inspiration from what our West African brothers, ASEC Mimosas, what they were able to do. They went to almighty El Ahly of Egypt away from home, and they got a win, a 2-1 win against El Ahly of Egypt. Decent result for ASEC. And if Enyimba want to stand any chance of going on in this competition and get a semi-final place, they just have to go away from home and try to get a result. Yeah. There's no argument about it.
That's
they
right.
must try to get a result away from home.
That's right, Tony. And ASEC, you know, they lost their first game at home too against Wydad Casablanca. And, you know, they have revived their campaign by going to Egypt, a very difficult place in Alexandria, and getting a 2-1 result against El Ahly. So I think for Enyimba, nothing is impossible. You can go to Egypt, you know, with the right formation, with the, you know, the players, you know, adopting the right mentality. You know, sometimes the players just refuse to function. And I think it's an indictment on the technical crew. You must get the right blend of players to get you the needed results.
All right, quickly, at your screen, El Ahly lost at 2-1 to ASEC. Sundown between the number 2-1. There's a game tomorrow, and that's going to be Wydad Athletic Club of Morocco against ZESCO United. That's conclude match day 2 of the CAF Champions League. We'll go on a quick break. When we return from the break, we'll talk Nigerian sports generally, the build-up to the Olympic Games, the search for a foreign coach on Sports Tonight. Join us again.